Assalamu alaikum everyone, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. On behalf of the platform by CGSS, I, Larry Hassan, welcome all of you to this exclusive online training session on the traits of public speaking, deliver to be known. As you all might know that many of our students and even a lot of us do not know how to deliver an impactful speech by public speaking. And it is a very important art that all of our students must know, because on many platforms they have this need to deliver their thoughts and pass on the message to a wider audience. So today we have with us a very special trainer, Mr. Tariq Khattak. He is a life coach, a motivational speaker, and also a member board of experts, CGSS. Over to you, sir.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah, as-Sami'ul Alim. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik. رب اشرح لي صدري امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. یہ دعا ہم کرتے ہیں جب اللہ تعالیٰ سے ہم کچھ دعا مانگتے ہیں کسی کے سامنے جا رہا ہے. اس میں ابتدا کروں گا کہ ہر ابتدا سے پہلے ہر انتہا کے بعد ذات نبی بلند ہے ذات خدا کے بعد. دنیا میں احترام کے قابل ہیں جتنے لوگ, میں سب کو مانتا ہوں مگر مصطفیٰ کے بعد. قتل حسین اصل میں مر کے یزید ہے, اسلام زندہ ہوتا ہے ہر کربلا کے بعد. میرے دوستو, ایک دن ہمارے آقا سرور کائنات سردار دو جہاں حضرت محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم سے ان کے صحابہ نے پوچھا کہ اللہ جل جلالہ نے جب یہ کائنات یہ جہاں نہیں بنایا تھا تو وہ کہاں تھا؟ تو جواب ملا کہ بادلوں میں تھا, گھنے بادلوں میں پنہا. اس کا حسن, اس کا جمال, اس کی کبریائی, اس کا جلوہ جو آج تم ہر جگہ دیکھتے ہو, وہ چھپا ہوا خزانہ تھا. تب اللہ تعالیٰ نے ارادہ کیا کہ میں اپنی ذات جو کہ ڈیفینیشن ہے حمد کی, اس کو ظاہر کروں. جس کا حسن تم آج ہر جگہ اپنے ارد گرد دیتے ہو, اس کو تمہارے سامنے اس دنیا میں محور بناؤں. تو وہ ظاہر کرنے کے لیے اپنی حسن کو, اپنے جمال کو, اپنی کبریائی کو ظاہر کرنے کے لیے اس نے خلق تخلیق کی. دوستو, جب آپ اپنے ہاتھ سے کوئی چیز بناتے ہیں, کوئی مٹی کا کھلونا, کوئی عمارت, کوئی بھی چیز, کوئی فن پارا, کوئی بچہ اپنا چھوٹا سا کوئی کھلونا بنا لیتا ہے, اس کو اس سے پیار ہونے لگتا ہے. وہ چاہتا ہے کہ وہ اس کے بارے میں لوگ بات کریں, اس کی تعریف کریں. اللہ رب العزت نے اپنی صفات کے مجموعے, اپنی جمال کے خزانوں اور اپنے حسن کے نور سے جو پہلی خلق بنائی, اس کے سحر میں اللہ رب العزت خود ہی میں ہو گیا. وہ خلق جو پہلی اللہ تعالیٰ نے بنائی, وہ کون تھا؟ وہ محمد مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم کی ذات تھی. اب اس کا نام محمد کیوں؟ تو سنو, خالق نے مخلوق کو جو بنایا تو اس مخلوق نے اپنی خالق کی تعریف کی جو کہ خالق نے ہی اس کو سکھائی. جب اس مخلوق نے خالق کی تعریف کی, ہم کی, تو وہ خالق محمود بنا. وہ خالق اپنے مخلوق کی حسن میں جو اسی کے جلبوں سے بنا تھا, اسی کے نور سے نکلا تھا, اس کی عشق میں اتنا محو ہو گیا کہ اس کی تعریف کیے بغیر نہ رہ سکا اور وہ محمد بنا. اب جس محبت سے ہمارے خالق نے ہمارے محمد مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کو بنایا اور وہ عشق کیا ان سے کہ اس ان کی ذات کو پوری کائنات کا ایک محور بنایا, تو پوچھو گے نہیں کہ ہمارے آقا کی محبت کیا ہے. ہمارے آقا کی محبت حسن اور حسین, اللہ تعالیٰ نے اپنی ذات میں سے جو کہ ہم کی صفت میں سے محمد بنایا, اپنے حسن کی صفت میں سے حسن اور حسین کو وہ نام دیے. حضرت علی کرم اللہ وجہ نے اپنے بیٹوں کا نام سب سے پہلے اپنے چچاؤں کے نام سے رکھا تھا, حمزہ اور عباس, لیکن اللہ تعالیٰ کے حسن سے حضور پاک صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے ان کے یہ نام تبدیل کرائے. اس دن سے پہلے ना इस कायनात में, ना इस पूरे जहान में, और ना उस आलम अरवा में किसी का नाम हसन और हुसैन नहीं था। वो नाम अल्लाह ताला ने अपने हुसन के पर्दों में छुपा दिया। अब जो हो तो माने, जिसका दिल हो तो जाने, जिसका ईमान ये है कि हज़रत पाक सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम की सोबत नसीब हो, उनका इश्क नसीब हो, वो इन शहज़ादों के बगैर हो नहीं सकता। रब तक रसाई चाहिए तो रफ्ता रफ्ता जीना चढ़ना पड़ेगा। जिसको रब ने मोहम्मद बनाया उसी को तरजीह बनानी पड़ेगी। उसको अपनी जात, अपनी औलाद, अपनी जान, अपनी माल, अपनी वालदैन से महबूब रखना पड़ेगा, तभी रब की तवज्जो नसीब होगी। ईमान भी डगमगा जाता है सारे रास्ते में। हमारे रब ने मोहम्मद से मोहब्बत की, हमारे मोहम्मद मुस्तफा सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम ने हुसैन से मोहब्बत की, तो हुसैन कौन पूछते हो ना? वो हुसैन के जब नाना के कंधों पर बैठे होते थे तो सजदे लंबे हो जाते। वो हुसैन जिसकी खातिर हमारे आका ने अपने अपने लख्ते जिगर को कुर्बान किया इब्राहिम अलैहिस्सलाम को। वो हुसैन जिसके लिए फरमाया कि हुसैन मुझसे है और मैं हुसैन से। ये वो हुसैन है जिसने नाना के दीन के खाते सर कटवाया लेकिन निगू ना किया। वो हुसैन जिसका सर नेजे पे भी कुरान की तिलावत करता जाता और यजीदियों के कलेजे चीरता चला जाता। ये वही हुसैन है जिससे हमारे आका ने इश्क किया। उसी से इश्क करोगे तो हमारे आका के इश्क के चाशनी में से हो सकता है आपको भी कुछ नसीब हो जाए। दोस्तों, ये छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल मैं देना चाह रहा था डिलीवरी का। ये छोटा सा एक नमूना आप लोगों को पेश करना चाह रहा था डिलीवरी का। और ऑब्वियसली इसको थोड़ा इसका हमारे मुहर्रम का जो महीना बरकत महीना चल रहा है उससे थोड़ा मैं रिलेट करना चाह रहा था। शॉर्ट जस्ट अबाउट आवर डेली दुनियावी जिंदगी, बट हमारे रिलीजियस कुछ ऑब्लिगेशंस भी हैं जिनको हम सामने रखें, तो लेट्स मेक इट अदर makes us very relevant to the whole situation aur jo hamare cheezein chal rahi hain. So is waqt hum the very idea of public speaking or going up there, hum baat karenge un logon ki jo ke is waqt hamare sath join kar rahe hain, to ho sakta hai ki usme aise log ho ke jo perceive kar rahe ho apne aap ko kal subah ya kabhi bhi kisi stage ya podium pe khade ho. देखिए, एक सिंपल बात है। There's a simple term. Small minds talk about things. Average minds talk about people. And greater minds talk about ideas. So let's talk ideas for this particular instant of this very session. Just for a single minute, just imagine yourself to be standing on a podium, having a dream and a passion which took you to that particular podium and made you able to be called on to that stage. Just imagine for a little while that you are that very particular leader that you want to be in your life. Whatever the sector, whatever the industry that you're working in, you can be a leader in it if you have that drive or passion. If you think about it, you imagine about it, you become that. So I hope whoever is joining us today, do get something and do extract something out of this session of ours today, that they would become the future leaders, the bosses, or the generals, and the alphas of our society. So, we were talking that this particular session is obviously whoever perceived himself or looks forward to becoming a leader in his sector, in his industry, in our nation, and I believe whoever is joining us today right now is a leader already born, is a leader already in the making. So that might be the only reason that particular person is joining us, because he has already imagined himself to be in this particular stage where he can deliver in this society by creating a better impact of whatever his experience and relevant accommodation with the society is. So we have gathered here today to like have 101s on the public speaking, how to deliver a good speech, whether you are in your school when you're called upon, or whether in your college or universities, in office presentations, sales pitches, public gatherings, or religious gatherings. So obviously the very fear of being called in, that it is now your turn. And I guess everybody has gone through this particular dilemma in life, that whenever your name is called in to speak on something that you have already been given a topic about or whatever, so the very ground shakes beneath your feet, and you just want to disappear out of that, or you would like to become an ostrich. So there's no place for you to hide in this society until and unless, because if we take the law of attraction, whatever you imagine about yourself and whatever the you perceive about yourself and whatever your objectives and goals in life are, Allah Rabbul Izzat is going to give you an opportunity, give you the venues to make you prepare for that particular reason. And that is the reason that most of the people, most of the political leaders, most of the scientists and such people are the people who have been always called in over the podium, in an assembly, in a school level, or in a college level. So public speaking isn't about going up there, becoming a political leader, but rather it's obviously, it's our day-to-day interaction with the social circles as well. So we are going to everybody can extract their own content out of their presentation here, whether they are relevant to whichever the category that we have here. Mostly public speaking is a generic form of something that you can follow and you can succeed and win hearts over through it. So let me just share a little story with you of mine. I was called in a night before that our religious teacher, our Murshid-e Pak, Hazrat Muhammad, उसमें थोड़ा सा स्टोरी रिलेट इस तरह करूंगा कि हमारे पीर बद्र आलम जान साहब की तरफ से मुझे कॉल आई कि पिछले साल उर्स के मुकाम पर आपने अपनी एक तकरीर करनी है. मुझे उस वक्त भी लाले पड़ गए कि करूं तो क्या करूं. सो लेकिन फिर भी सारी रात बैठ के कुछ लिखा, कुछ पढ़ा, कुछ डर था कि इतने बड़े उलमा के सामने कैसे बोलूंगा मैं, एक नाचीज अदना शागिर्द क्या बोलूंगा उनके सामने. लेकिन जब वो दिन आया, इंतजार करता रहा, एक घंटा गुजरा, दो घंटे गुजरे, तीन घंटे गुजरे, इंतजार करता रहा और कुछ मिनट पहले मुझे ये पता चला कि मैं जब अभी स्टेज पे जा रहा हूं तो आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू बी स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ 4,000 or 5,000 लाइव ऑडियंस जो कि उस वक्त हमारे सामने बैठी थी स्टेज के नीचे, बट रादर दैट पर्टिकुलर प्रोग्राम वॉज वॉच्ड बाय मिलियंस over different live channels as well. ARY पे चल रहा था different चीजों. मुझे वहाँ पे मेरी टांगें कामना शुरू हो गई. The fear was there, लेकिन still अल्लाह ने बड़ा करम किया. दोस्तों ने काफी साथ दिया. And I delivered the speech and everything. But I do relate to the people who have that stage fright. लेकिन उस दिन के बाद से मुझे एक चीज realize हुई कि the stage fright is something that is in your own mind. Somebody has already chosen you, or somebody has already chosen you, or they consider yourself able enough to like go up there on the podium and deliver that speech of yours. You're already there. Jab aapko koi bula leta hai, you're already there on that podium. You deserve it. That is the reason you're up there, and the rest of the people are standing beneath you, in front of you, trying to listen to you, waiting for you to win their hearts over and their minds over and their ideas over, because you're already there. You can do it, right? And it's your time to shine at that particular moment. You just need to relax, take a deep breath, relax again, and do not over prepare whatever you are preparing. Over preparation leads to your sort of like a curriculum type of approach, and it becomes robotic, a robotic speech. And also, there's a perception that if you don't prepare your speech and you write it down and you're up there, you'll start reading it. But as per my own personal experience, when you over-prepare your speech or whatever the delivery that you're giving, even then you start reading from whatever the content you have. So it's better to write it down once, rehearse it a few times, go through the content and take notes out of it. Read, but put your own punch into the whatever the delivery you have. Obviously, so let's talk about a little about the kind of speakers that we have in our society right now, the current speakers. So obviously, the main fundamentals of any speaking or any speech or any delivery or any presentation even, you can extract that things out, those things out of it. The very conviction in a speech can be found in Arjuna Sahib's speeches. He had a desire, he had a passion to convey his message to the people that it's time to weigh part from the rest of the Indian and get our own nation for it. Zulfikar Ali Bhutto, no political affiliations here, right? So he was the greatest speaker who could relate to his audience and who could take them into the imagination, to his conviction and desire, whatever his own motives were, personal motives were. But at least he took millions and millions of Pakistanis back in the 70s decades to come up with a revolution that affected the whole nation at that particular time. And then the conviction, Dr. Tahirul Qadri, seriously, as far as the religious speakers are concerned, I'm a big fan of his. I'm a follower as well. I listen to his lectures and I read about his books. And even the first speech in Urdu that I just gave is also was also inspired from one of his speeches. His conviction to deliver the very idea of Khatm-e-Nubuwwat is what is required these days. People relate to it because he conveys, he transfers his own conviction and desire of that particular passion so that everybody would be engulfed in that very idea. He transfers it to his audience, whether he's sitting on a screen or even if he's sitting in front of a live audience with an advisor, obviously, Qasim Ali Shah Sahib. He speaks your heart. He speaks about your issues. He relates to it and he cannot... Like, obviously, Qasim Ali Shah Sahib is a kind of a person. He cannot be without giving you some sort of an advice. Even if it's in his personal life, if you're sitting with him, he would give you an advice about at least something. So, obviously, and charm, again, Jinnah Sahib, charm. The charm in his brought up, the charm in his education, and then Imran Khan Sahib, obviously, everybody is like engulfed in his... charming personality right now. There might be a little bit of an objection on this very particular part that his speeches are not that charming, but his personality is, yes. But obviously, it's a complete package. If you are out there and if you're speaking, if your personality is there, you would convey that personality to the very audience that you have. And then storytelling. Storytellers are the people who tell you stories so that you can relate to it. Tariq Jameel Sahib is one of the biggest examples right now. He tells a story, he leads you with that story to something, the very message that he wants you to attain and extract from that particular lecture of his. In the meanwhile, you have seen people crying in his lectures as well. You've seen people laughing in his lectures as well. You've seen people going into a thought-provoking process as well. And then believer, Ali Muhammad Khan Sahib. I know him personally. And whatever he says in his speeches, he believes about it. He acts on it. So when your belief translates into your words, the person sitting in front of you starts realizing and admitting the very desire and conviction and objective and goals and everything in your life, and he starts relating to it. He perceives himself in that same aura that you're trying to build through your speeches. And arrogance, obviously, is Altaf Hussain Sahib. So I don't give a dash about anybody else. I would say whatever I want and I would. So that's arrogance. I don't know that I won't recommend that kind of a speech on everything. And then the authority. If you have heard General Ayub Khan Sahib's 1965's war speech, that was the authority, that was the delivery that not just meant for the nation to stand together with him, but rather he delivered a very solid message in response to the Indian retaliation at that time that this is not the way, and we are going to give you a good example in this, and we are going to give you a good reaction to this. And the same happened the last February with the Pakistan and Indian nation as well. Imran Khan also delivered a very authoritative speech in that particular instant. And then that is the authority when a sort of a leader is sitting in front of you and speaking, right? But then your authority also becomes when you have the knowledge of whatever you are speaking about. And that is the reason why Professor Ahmed Rafiq Akhtar Sahab, a sort of a building of knowledge of religious psychology and whatever you can like, and then Dr. Istar Ahmed Sahab, when he delivers a speech, he delivers the idea of Islam. When Ahmed Rafiq Akhtar Sahab speaks, he delivers his mind to the people so that people would start thinking about the idea, the subject that he's talking about. But that authority comes only with the knowledge that you have about it. So the main ingredients of a good delivery, that is something that you would need to, the last slide, this is something that you would need to identify in your own personality, what kind of a person you already are, how much passion or the desire you already have for your objective, what would you like to be, and why are you standing on that particular stage in front of a mic, in front of 10 people or 1,000 people or 1,000,000 people, and why are you speaking those words out, right? So you need to discover yourself first, which kind of a speaker you already are, whether you are a conviction level, whether you have that desire to prove yourself, whether you are at an advisor level, whether you are a charming personality or like any other Hollywood or Lollywood or personalities or celebrities and stuff like that. So you need to identify yourself first, and then obviously the main ingredients of a good delivery. Obviously, the first part comes that you prepare for it, right? You read for it. You prepare for the whatever the topic you have. You're not just given any opportunity to speak at a public procession or anything, or in front of your audience in a corporate society, or in front of your school or college out of the blue. That rarely happens. Normally, you are given a subject to talk about. So you need to prepare for it. You need to first read about it, do some research about it. But to a certain level, that you do not lose your own self in that whatever you have written for that particular audience of yours. So the biggest thing is to find your own voice in yourself. Find your own desire and the drive in yourself. Which kind of a speaker are you, right? Then you would be able to deliver your own voice. Being somebody else isn't going to like work for you. If I start talking up right now, mimicking somebody else, you're not going to be impressed about anything, right? Actually, going further, sorry, Lara, is my voice okay now, Lara?
Yes, sir, your voice is absolutely fine.
Thank you very much. Okay, so and second thing, when you're your own self, obviously you're becoming sincere with your own personal self as well. And that leads to your sincerity with the very topic that you're going to discuss in front of somebody or present in front of somebody in a corporate society. In a corporate environment, you're presenting something. I've seen, and I have hundreds of presentations I've been given in front of me by different startups and businesses and people and candidates for jobs and stuff like that. They try to be somebody else. They are not sincere with the very idea that they present in front of me or in front of you or in front of whatever the idea is. So this being yourself, finding your voice, finding your personality, and then the sincerity, putting that sincerity in it, the belief in it, leads to the conviction that basically relates your audience to the very subject that you're talking in front of them. The power of persuasion, relating to the people, reasons, rational reasons. How would you persuade them for the very idea that you are there? The power of persuasion comes from repetition as well. is a simple example in our country, which is Imran Khan sir. He kept on telling people again and again that the particular family, the Sharif family, are not good people and they are so and so and so, right? And people started believing in it. And the very people who were also following them, they also started following Imran Khan. And even that particular slogan that came out of that dharna of ours, of Imran Khan's, that led it to be famous even in the African countries. Small children as young as 4 years old and 5 years old starting following that slogans, chanting that slogans, because the power of persuasion was there, because he had the charm in his delivery, he had the conviction in his delivery, he had the desire in his delivery, and he had that very objective and sincerity because he knew what he's talking about and he knew what his goal is. So people started following him. People started saying the very words that he wanted them to say. And how does that come in? Through your creating your authority. The very first thing that you do is to make the first eye contact with your audience, and your voice matters as well. Alhamdulillah, most of the people have good voices. They need to identify that voice as well, so that they can, whenever they start speaking, the very first 3 or 4 words out of your mouth, whenever you start speaking in a public place or in a presentation, needs to be stood first, needs to be hardened words, needs to be, because once you are through with that first minute of your sentence, once you are through with that first minute of your sentence in your speech, you're good to go after that. Once you win over your audience through that first sentence, you're good to go for the rest of your whatever the delivery is. So eye contact, the voice, and then the body language. Loosen up. Use your hands. Use your whatever the podium that you have. Walk around on the podium. If it's a presentation, walk around in front of the pitching deck out there. And then the pitch matters. And the speed of the words delivery matters. If you're too fast about it, nobody's going to understand you. Nobody's going to relate it to you because you're going too fast. And always the speeches are such in which people would like to think about what you, every sentence that you're saying in it. That's the main objective of any good speaker, that whatever the sentence he says, the audience starts thinking about it or goes in their own imagination to that particular place. So whenever your speech is in a good speed where they can start imagining it, that they are sitting there in whatever the story you're telling them or relating them, right? So they would be able to be in sync with you. If you're too speedy, if your delivery is too speedy, they would not be able to sync in with you and they would lose you after a few minutes of whatever the speech that you have. And relating to the audience, as I just shared one of my experiences here with you, and before that I related a short speech of mine with the Muharram month this right now. So start relating your speech to the public, right? Personal experiences are shared with the audiences, not that you can get pity out of them, or not that you can just at least fill a spot in your speech, but rather you can relate that personal experience of yours, because right now we are talking about delivering a good speech or delivering a good presentation, let's suppose, and I had shared a story with you which was my own stage fright and my own experience of getting challenged when I was called in on a major stage. So it is relevant to the very idea on the very subject that we are talking in right now. So I have already related it to you that I have gone through this thing, and let's talk about improving the whole thing. There was a story in it. You could relate to it. the emotions were there. I don't know how many of you are like you need to put that emotion into that particular story of your and speech of your, because if you have the previous traits that I told you and you have identified what your strength is in your personality, then you can put that very emotion into your speech as well. Because the people sitting in front of you have already sitting there because they have already decided that they want you, the speaker, to win their hearts over. They already want you to deliver the very idea through which they can be impressed. They are mentally already that you can deliver a speech, a few words, so that they can relate it to one of their issues, one of their life problems, or one of their job problems or whatever, so that they can, it's simple as that. You are up there and they are not, right? End of story. Okay, so there are basically three parts of any good speech and delivery, right? The start, the middle, and the end. I'll go through them. So the start, again, relax, be yourself, and be humble about it. Humble, but the very first mistake that most of the speakers do is they apologize when they start their speaking. They apologize on things that they do not, they start admitting in front of people that they do not know what they're talking about. They're already sitting in front of you, ready to listen to you on the subject that has already been marketed out there, right? And your name has already been printed or displayed or marketed out there. Why are you apologizing in front of people? You've made it there. It's your time to shine. Just shine. Just deliver. Enjoy it. Take a deep breath. Gather all your thoughts, whatever the preparation that you have, what just focus. Whatever the preparation you had, focus on that. Stop remembering the words that you have written for your speech. Even stop remembering the notes. When you are at a good level, and you when you have a few sessions done, you just need to have a glance at you whatever the notes you had, and you are good to go. And again, the start, engage them right from the start through a story, through relating to them. For example, if I'm I'm visiting a certain city, Islamabad, right? Or Aptaba. Let's take Aptaba, it's a smaller city, right? So if I'm going there, right, and I'm delivering a speech there, and if I tell them, okay, I have spent 3 years of my, three very good years of my life in this particular city while having a job here, and I enjoyed the hell out of it, and I went to the particular restaurant, and then I went to the this particular hill station in Aptabad and everything, and they would start relating with you, and they would start imagining you to be that you are already amongst them. You are there already, right? So you have already won them over. So that's a way to start relating to your audience. And if obviously, if you're not in that particular area, you have not been there, you can find out a number of things wherever you are, wherever you're delivering your speech. If it's a corporate environment, you can have a research done on the very company and whatever. At least you can deliver something and relate something to anybody. Tell a story. Tell an anecdote, tell a small joke or whatever, but start solid. Start solid with your voice, with your body language, and prepare for your start as if you have never prepared for anything in your life. The middle. So the middle of any speech is mostly the content that continues. If it's a political speech, you would continue
saying the same things over and over again. It doesn't, that really matters if it's a lecture or a presentation. Obviously the technical things would come over and you would start sharing information and everything and in the engagement. So the middle part is something that you need to stick to the subject, relate to what you have said in the start, lead to something that you are going to say at the end of the speech, right? So the middle is basically not as a pie, but rather it's the, if you reverse the whole constituents of the pie, right? So the start and the end are the most crucial part of any speech. Not for the technical lectures and stuff like that, but rather for any public speaking or political speaking or presentations and stuff like that, right? So the start and the end matters. The mid is a leading section. It relates back to the start of the speech and the subject. And also it leads to the very ending of the speech and the subject. So it is important, but rather you need to just tell them what you already told them. Tell them again in the middle, and at the end, tell them again. And that is going to put you in a very solid spot where you initially were. And then the end. Plan the ending as the start. It matters because the start does matter. The middle does matter. In my opinion, not as much, but it does matter. At least 60 or 70%. But the ending is where people would remember you, what you have been talking to them for the last 30 minutes, 40 minutes, an hour or so. You need to leave a keynote with them. You need to leave them with a thought-provoking idea, a question out there so that they would start thinking about it. And never make your conclusions long. Keep it shorter. And with the same style with which you started your speech right from the beginning. Be graceful about it. I've seen most of the people, serious people and senior people as well, delivering a very good speech at a certain level. And at the end of the day, they end up delivering a kind of a joke or something that leaves the audiences in a question here. This person had left a good impression in the first 15 minutes of his speech, and the kind of joke that he had shared right now doesn't relate to his personality. And I just shared this the ending gesture of Shahbaz Sharif when he does these things a lot. Does anybody remember what Shahbaz Sharif said in that particular speech of his? Nobody does. But everybody remembers what he did with the mics and everything, right? So that's the end, the impression, the big impression. Okay, so again, remember to be remembered. There's no rocket science to public speaking. It's just your own confidence, finding your own self, finding your own voice, and focusing on the very subject that you're delivering and focusing on the audience that's sitting in front of you. So find your voice, be yourself, and do not be somebody else, and prepare for it, read about it, rehearse it. Don't memorize your speech. Rehearse it again and again and again, and emphasize on words, your convictions, emotions, the authoritative words in your speech matters a lot, because those words are there to deliver your idea, the conviction and the body language. If you add the body language with that particular conviction, if I'm right now, if you're looking at me and I'm saying the word conviction and I'm doing my punch out there, right? So I'm already delivering something and want you to like see that this is what I believe in. If you have noticed, I have kept my voice a little higher, one because of the technical issue, and also one because I wanted to deliver something in a manner so that you may conceive that I have the authority over this particular subject, right? So emphasize on words. And the pauses in your speeches are the very crucial thing, because the pauses lets you gather your thoughts. The pauses lets you gather yourself, and if you have lost somewhere in that particular speech, the pauses would lead you to regather your linings and thoughts and process and whatever, or at least if there's any sort of disturbance in that thing in the audience, you can have a good pause in it and restart from where you left off and focus on the audience. Your audience, as I said earlier, you already want you to win their heart over. They're sitting there because they want to be there. They're sitting there because they want you to win them over. And through your words, through your speech, and one thing that I would like to add here is a good speaker should always be good enough to write as well, because nobody else can write the speech for you for the very subject that you have the desire and conviction for and the passion for, and he cannot translate that particular emotion of yours into his own words when it comes to writing a speech. So a good speaker, if he wants to be out there, he needs to be a good writer as well. It can be learned. But for you to be enabled to have a good writing skills, you need to read as well. You need to have some research done as well. And that would be the only way that you can win your audience over through your own thoughts, because your words written by your own self can deliver your own original emotions and desire over to the audiences that you want to win over. So, Lareb, are we okay here?
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can. Was the voice okay for the rest of the presentation?
Yes, sir. Your voice is absolutely perfect.
Okay. So, how many participants do we have right now?
We have 40 participants, sir.
MashaAllah. So, let's have a small exercise now. Let's choose out a few participants and choose out whoever wants to have a delivery for 2 minutes speech. Mr. Romani, are you there? You're working on some papers out there. Let's have a few words from you on a certain topic out there. So, I'll be giving like 5 minutes to prepare the
just in the city. That's
to the no response.
Yeah.
Right. So let's. People who would like to like say a few words for 2 minutes in this particular exercise can raise their hand so that Lareb can choose them out, and we can have like a 2 minute speech done, and you have like 5 minutes to deliver your speech.
Okay, everyone, this is an open stage for you. I think this is your moment that you can finally do some public speaking right now. So whoever is interested, please voluntarily raise your hand, or we will just call out your name and unmute your mic. So it's better if you raise your hand.
Yeah, so is anybody interested? How many have, Lareb, how many have left once we announced this exercise?
Only one has left the meeting. Now we have
30. Yeah, note kar lege, wo kaun tha. Yeah, so, kitna time goes again?
Sir, we have already passed an hour. I think 2 minutes are over, but none of our participants have raised their hand yet.
Adiba Rahman raised her hand.
We have a volunteer. Okay,
yeah, Adiba. MashaAllah.
MashaAllah. Okay, Adiba, I am unmuting your mic. Yes, okay.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yes, we can, loud and clear, Adiba. Thank you for coming over and taking the initiative. You are the leader in all.
Thank you to you, sir. I'm Adiba from NUST University, and I would like to share something about my own experience that I went through in very first semester of my bachelor life. And this is very interesting for those who are actually joining this session to learn something about this public speaking. Actually, what happened was there was a group of people in my university. And, they were asking us to say something about entrepreneurship. And at that moment, I knew what entrepreneurship is, but I did not know how to actually convey my words. And there was some certificate at the end of that competition. And I said that in mixed Urdu and English, and that whole experience was like I was on fire for such a competition. It was nothing, but I had this in me that I need to speak about it because I know what entrepreneurship is, and I got done with it, and I got the certificate, and after that I had this feeling that I can do it. And with that little achievement, I feel like I have achieved so much in that public speaking, not just since my bachelor life, but now I'm doing master. And I still feel accomplished till this day that if I had not taken the step to speak on that day, I think I would have felt that I am the loser, and I couldn't speak. Hello?
Yes, Adiba, we heard your experience, we heard your story, and thank you so much for sharing it. Over to you, Sir Tariq.
So, thank you very much, Adiba, for being the very first initiator here to like start off this public, I would call it a podium, because as you had shared your experience, so you are already a leader in a making. But the experience that you had just shared with us is something that I would just like to point out something in whatever you said out there. Is, I don't know, you didn't mention whether you have like continued on speaking in such occasions or not. But if you have not, and you are still cherishing on that very memory that you had back then, and you still consider yourself to be better at it, right? So, mere khayal mein phir aapko thoda sa aage move karne ki zarurat hai. Because cherishing on something that has been the past, currently aapko wo jo aapki mein wo ability hai jo aapko us din identify hui, usko ab aap aage lekar jaye. Usko ab aap और भी फ्रूटफुल बनाए आपके लिए. मैं थोड़ा सा अपना एक छोटा सा एक्सपीरियंस और शेयर कर लेता हूँ. यूएस में पिछले साल यूएस में फिलाडेल्फिया में वी हैड आई हैड गॉन देयर. सो कुछ कॉर्पोरेट इवेंट्स थे, कुछ मीटिंग्स थी, लेकिन इन द ग्रुप दैट आई हैड आई वाज चोजन एज अ लीडर अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह देयर एज वेल टू लाइक लीड द होल इंटरनेशनल ग्रुप इन फ्रंट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ द मीटिंग्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कंडक्ट देयर. सो अब मैं जब सुबह उठे फिलाडेल्फिया में एक बहुत बड़े कॉर्पोरेट सेटअप में, तीन चार बड़े जिसमें एडोब वगैरह के भी ऑफिस हैं, वहां के भी जीएम्स वगैरह आए हुए थे, उन्होंने कहा कि यार यू आर गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ स्पीच देयर. एंड वी हैड लाइक 40 मिनट्स ड्राइव टू दैट स्पेस, टू दैट पर्टिकुलर वेन्यू, एंड आई हैड टू प्रिपेयर अ स्पीच टू बी डिलीवर्ड बिफोर द इवेंट स्टार्ट्स. And present the whole 20 nations that I was sort of like representing there as well, as their lead there. So अब मैं बस में बैठ के हेडफोन्स लगा के ये सोचता रहा कि यार बोलूं तो क्या बोलूं, जहां हम जा रहे हैं उसके बारे में तो अभी हमें पता ही नहीं है, आप कुछ इवेंट अटेंड करते हैं तो आपको पता चलता है कि क्या था। तो मैं कहा चलो यार रॉकी तो सबने देखी है एंड इट्स वन ऑफ माय फेवरेट मूवीज एज वेल, और रॉकी का जो वो स्टैचू है जहां पर वो सीढ़ियों पे चढ़ के दौड़ के ऊपर जाता है, ठीक है, वो फिलाडेल्फिया में ही है। सो वो दिमाग में आया, यूट्यूब खोला, जल्दी जल्दी रॉकी का एक दो तीन स्पीचेस उठाए और उससे रिलेट करके मैंने फिर वहां पे वो स्पीच डिलीवर की फॉर अराउंड 10 or 12 minutes। जो टिपिकल बुकिश बातें उस इवेंट में थी वो अपनी जगह थी, लेकिन बिलीव मी जब मैंने वहां पे रॉकी की बातें शुरू की एंड व्हेन आई कोटेड रॉकी द वेरी स्पीच दैट ही गेव टू हिज सन इन वन ऑफ द आई गेस इन रॉकी 5 और समथिंग, पीपल स्टार्टेड रिलेटिंग टू व्हाट आई वाज सेइंग। और उसके बाद अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह अल्लाह इज्जत देने वाला है, उसके बाद सारे लोग मेरी तरफ ही, मैं उसका सेंटर स्टेज बन गया था उस सारे इवेंट का। सो वो एक एक्सपीरियंस चेरिश करता हूं मैं अभी भी, जो मैंने अभी यहां पे दूसरी स्टोरी शेयर की वो भी मैं चेरिश करता हूं, इसके अलावा और भी काफी स्टोरीज है, लेकिन आई मूव ऑन। मैं आज अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह अल्लाह की तौफीक से जो आप लोगों के सामने यहां बैठ के आपसे बातें कर रहा हूं, सो यू नीड टू मूव ऑन। अच्छा लारेब, इज देयर एनीबॉडी एल्स?
No, sir, I don't think so, because no one has raised their hand yet. Ek ko main,
nahi,
we have two more volunteers. Okay. One is Ms. Hamna Hashmi. So, Hamna Hashmi, I am unmuting your mic now.
Assalamualaikum. I also wanted to share my experience. I am a student of Khairiazam University. I was a student of Khairiazam University. I did my MSc in psychology, completed last year. मैं अपना experience ये बताना चाह रही थी कि when I was in my first semester, so जब हमारी पहली presentation थी तो उससे पहले मतलब कोई दो दिन तक मैंने उसके सही रट्टे लगाए, याद किया उस प्रेजेंटेशन देने से पहले। बट व्हेन इन माय फोर्थ सेमेस्टर व्हेन आई हैड टू गिव माय प्रेजेंटेशन, सो हम सुबह उठ के उसको थोड़ा सा पढ़ लेते थे और उसके बाद हम प्रेजेंटेशन दे देते। लाइक इट कम विद प्रैक्टिस कि पहले सेमेस्टर में दो तीन दिन तक टेंशन होती थी कि पता नहीं प्रेजेंटेशन होगी क्या होगा, और उसके बाद फोर्थ सेमेस्टर तक आते आते इतनी प्रैक्टिस हो गई थी कि हम सुबह उठ के इसको कर लेते थे, मतलब एक ही घंटा या आधे घंटे में जो भी टॉपिक प्रिपेयर करना होता था। एंड आफ्टर द गैप ऑफ लाइक आई कंप्लीट माय डिग्री इन जनवरी और अब इतने 8 महीने तो हो गए हैं, सो इट्स लाइक आई एम आउट ऑफ प्रैक्टिस ऑफ स्पीकिंग, सो हाउ टू कीप अप विद दैट प्रैक्टिस व्हेन यू डोंट हैव एनीवन any crowd to talk to, इसमें अगर आप कोई suggestion दें तो it would be really fruitful for me. Thank you, and this session was great. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Hamna. देखिए, the thing is, how would you like start doing what you like to do, which is the public speaking? Is आपके घर में शीशा है, आपके फोन में सेल्फी मोड है, ठीक है, और आजकल यूट्यूब इतना मुश्किल काम नहीं है, यू कैन जस्ट पुट योर हार्ट आउट इन व्हाटएवर द कंटेंट दैट यू हैव, व्हाटएवर द काइंड ऑफ। देखिए एक चीज है, अगर आपको कोई ऐसी अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलती है कि आप पब्लिक स्पीकिंग करें, दैट इज समथिंग डिफरेंट, राइट, आप स्टेज पे जाए वो करें, लेकिन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू समथिंग एंड यू वॉन्ट टू बी नोन इन इट, राइट, so you have the social media platform to start doing whatever you want to. Just put your heart out in whatever you want to say in your vlogs, in whatever you want to say on your Facebook page. Zaruri nahi hai ki hamare mulk ke upar ek thoda sa ek political ek wo kehte hain ek chadar chad gayi ki har ek banda political pe hi baatein karna chahta hai. Yaar, you can talk about whatever the idea that you have, you can talk about whatever the good things that you can share in your daily life, you can talk about anything. Original content matters. Originality in any speaking or any content, in any video content or any writing content matters. So you can start off right now. And to be very honest, mere khayal mein Larab aur hamari team aur Palvasha and hamari CGSS ki team aur the platform ki team, we welcome people like you who are willing to speak their heart out in front of the people if they have some sort of an idea, a topic to discuss. You have been a student of Qaid-e Azam University, the most prestigious institution in the whole of the nation. Get in touch with Larab, come up with a topic, and we would give you the very platform to talk to the people publicly. That is what the platform by CGSS is. Our idea of creating this particular and naming our organization platform, yehi idea hai uske piche ki, that the people and the leaders of making jo alphas hamari society mein reh rahe hain, wo samne aaye. So Hamna, we'll be expecting your call sooner to Larab. Larab, you can get in touch with her and get her contacts as well. And secondly, Hamna, if you have publicly expressed your wish and will to speak publicly, now we are going to go after you and force you to do so. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Hamna, for sharing your experience with us. And as Sir Tariq mentioned, the platform, we have created this platform for students like you, jinke paas agar aapko feel hota hai ki aapme koi talent hai, और या तो अगर आपके पास कोई ऐसी स्किल है जिसको आप और पॉलिश करना चाहते हैं तो दिस इज अ प्लेटफॉर्म के जहां पे हम आपको अपॉर्चुनिटीज देते हैं. वी हैव मोर वॉलंटियर्स विद अस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई लाइक टू इनवाइट मिस्टर मोहम्मद फारूक लगारी. ओके फारूक, आई एम अनम्यूटिंग योर माइक.
जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम टू एवरीवन. आई वांट टू शेयर माय एक्सपीरियंस सर. जब फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जब मैं 8th क्लास में था तो मुझे जो है ना स्कूल की तरफ से कंपटीशन में जो है ना पार्टिसिपेट करने का मौका मिला. तो उस वक्त इंग्लिश स्पीच के तौर पर इंग्लिश स्पीच में मैंने पार्टिसिपेट किया था. तो जब मेरे जो प्रिंसिपल साहब हैं उन्होंने मुझे डिफरेंट जो है ना स्पीकर के पास ले गए कि जो इनके इसके अंदर जो है ना मोटिवेशन जो है ना इसको पैदा करें कि ये स्पीच कर सके. तो पहले तो मैं झिझक महसूस करता था, लेकिन उस वक्त एक जो जज साहबान पहले रह चुके थे तो उन्होंने मुझे कहा कि आप एक इस तरह कीजिएगा कि आईने के सामने अपना जो है ना प्रैक्टिस कीजिएगा और यही देखिएगा कि मैं अपने से जो है ना बातें कर रहा हूँ. तो जब आप उधर जाएंगे तो आप अपने जहन में भी जो है ना यही कंसिडर कीजिएगा कि मेरे सामने कुछ भी नहीं है, बस वही जो मैं पहले अकेला खुद से ही बातें कर रहा हूँ. तो आप बड़े अच्छे तरीके से जो है ना उसको स्पीक कर पाएंगे. तो अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह सर, मैं उस वक्त फिर फर्स्ट पोजीशन अपने डिस्ट्रिक्ट में मैंने जो है ना हासिल की थी. उसके बाद मुझे मौका मिला एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ फैसलाबाद MSc के प्रीवियस ईयर में. अभी तो मैं MPhil का स्टूडेंट हूँ मैथमेटिक्स. तो प्रीवियस ईयर में जब मैंने गया तो मुझे एक क्लास फेलो ने कहा कि यार ये इतनी ऑडियंस होगी तो आप जो है ना करें, इस तरह इंसल्ट होगी आपकी तो आप नहीं कर पाएंगे. तो मेरे जहन में फिर वही जो है ना 8th क्लास वाले कि मैं इंशाल्लाह कर पाऊंगा. तो मैंने पूरी रात जो है ना प्रैक्टिस की आईने के सामने खड़े होकर. तो इतना बाद में मैंने जब स्पीच की अगले दिन तो इतना अप्रिशिएट हमारे जो प्रोफेसर साहब हैं उन्होंने बुला कर किया कि काफ़ी अच्छी स्पीच आपने की है. तो ये जो मेरा थोड़ा सा एक्सपीरियंस था कि सामने वाले को इस तरह मैनेज करें कि इमेजिन करें कि ये सामने मेरे बैठे ही नहीं है, या इस तरह आप खुद से ही बातें कर रहे हैं तो आप अच्छे तरीके से जो है ना कोई टॉक कर सकते हैं, बात कर सकते हैं. तो ये थोड़ा सा था सर, आप अपना एक्सपीरियंस जो है ना मैंने जो शेयर करना. थैंक यू, अल्लाह हाफिज़.
थैंक यू सो मच फारूक.
थैंक यू लगारी साहब, थैंक यू वेरी मच. देखिए द थिंग इज लगारी साहब, कि हमारी जिंदगी है, हम जीते हैं, हमें पता है कि मेरी एबिलिटीज क्या है, हमें पता है कि मैं किन लोगों के सामने बोल सकता हूँ, हमें पता. देखें, इट्स सिंपल एज दैट. अगर आपको पहली दफा कहीं बोलने का मौका है तो लोगों को ना देखें, आंखें नीचे कर लें, लेकिन एटलीस्ट हैव द स्ट्रेंथ टू गो इन फ्रंट ऑफ द पीपल. पोडियम पे तो खड़े हो जाए ना. देखिए, मैं शुरू में जब मैंने कहा कि यू आर ऑलरेडी देयर, यू हैव बीन चोजन टू बी देयर बाय समबडी, कि आपको बोल रहे हैं, वो उनमें आपको वो आप में उनको वो एबिलिटी नजर आ रही थी, तो तभी वो कह रहे थे कि आके कुछ बात कर दो या कुछ स्पीच कर दो या कोई प्रेजेंटेशन कर दो या व्हाटएवर, राइट? तो जब नॉलेज आपके पास है, आप में एबिलिटी है, तो फिर आप जब खाना खाते हैं तो किसी और से पूछते हैं कि मैं खाना खाऊं कि ना खाऊं? जब आप कोई जोक देखते हैं और उस पर हंसते हैं तो आप किसी और से पूछते हैं कि जोक पे मैं हंसूं कि ना हंसूं? इट्स आवर ओन लाइफ, ये हम करते हैं, हमने अपने डिसीजंस खुद लेने हैं। वो मशहूर गाना क्या था जो मेरे ख्याल में अर्ली 90s में था, आई डोंट नो ज्यादा पार्टिसिपेंट्स उस एज के होंगे कि नहीं, लेकिन इट्स माय लाइफ, तो मैं क्या पता नहीं क्या मेरी जिंदगी है, आई डोंट गिव अ डैम अबाउट यू, राइट? सो दैट्स द अप्रोच यू नीड टू हैव इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लाइफ। एंड एक और चीज ऑन अ फाइनल नोट, अलारे और तो कोई नहीं है?
जी जी
प्लीज प्लीज टेक टेक इट।
We have Ms. Adila Ahmed with us. Adila, I have unmuted your mic. Yes, Adila.
Assalamu alaikum. Sir, the session is very fruitful for me. और मैं काजी आजम यूनिवर्सिटी से मैंने MPhil किया हुआ है और मुल्तान से मैं पढ़ के उधर गई थी और अपनी प्रेजेंटेशन जो थी ना उसको मैंने इम्प्रूव किया इसी तरह शीशे के सामने खड़े होके और सारा। और अब कुछ अरसे के बाद मैंने फील किया कि पब्लिक स्पीकिंग में ना मैंने टॉक शो भी किया रिसेंटली ना, वही अपना एक फियर को ख़त्म करने के लिए एक डेयर स्टेप उठाया कि इसको मैंने चैलेंज को चैलेंज करके कि इसको ख़त्म करना है। मुझे सईद आसिफ रज़ा ने कॉल की थी तो सर मैं ये शेयर करना चाहती हूँ, जब मैं बोलने लगती हूँ तो आइडियाज़ मेरे जहन में बहुत होते हैं लेकिन मैं उनको कामली एक्सप्रेस नहीं कर पाती और मेरी हार्ट बीट और सांस तेज हो जाती है, तो आई वॉन्ट टू ओवरकम दैट। और दूसरा पॉइंट ये कि मैं मूव ऑन करना चाहती हूँ क्योंकि मैंने आर्टिकल राइटिंग स्टार्ट की हुई है, न्यूज़पेपर में लिखती हूँ, लेकिन जब मैं किसी पब्लिक फोरम पे बोलने की बात आती है तो एक रेजिस्टेंस आ जाती है, मेरे जहन में सवाल आने लग जाते हैं क्या मैं कर पाऊँगी, क्या मैं बोल पाऊँगी अपना वो चीज़ को, तो वो एक डर है अभी तक और मैं उसको ख़त्म करना चाहती हूँ। और मुझे ऐसे लगता है कि मैं कर पाऊँगी लेकिन एक बस वो एक मुझे एक वो एक चाहिए चीज उसको ओवरकम करने के लिए। थैंक यू,
थैंक यू वेरी मच।
फिर आप उन दोनों का आंसर एक साथ दे दीजिएगा। वी हैव वन मोर क्वेश्चन विद अस। ओके ओके, सो आवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम मिस्टर शफकत रसूल। शफकत, आई हैव अनम्यूटेड योर माइक, यू कैन गो ऑन एंड आस्क योर क्वेश्चन।
जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम, जी शफकत अब्बासी, मैं IR का स्टूडेंट हूँ, नमन यूनिवर्सिटी से अभी मास्टर डन किया है मैंने, तो मेरे साथ भी यही इशू है, प्रेजेंटेशन जब भी देता हूँ या तो मेरे पास IR का स्टूडेंट हो, IR का स्टूडेंट वो सोशल होता है वैसे, तो मैं वैसे सोशल भी हूँ बहुत ज़्यादा, जो भी पाकिस्तान में ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑपरेट करती है तो उसमें भी काम करता हूँ, तो मेरे पास नॉलेज भी है, गोल्स भी हैं, ऑब्जेक्ट्स भी हैं मेरे, और मोटिवेशन भी है, और पॉलिटिकल पार्टी से भी मैं ताल्लुक रखता हूँ, तो डायरेक्शन भी मिली हुई है, प्लेटफॉर्म भी मौजूद है, तो मतलब मैं अपने आप को डिलीवर नहीं कर पाता, तो मेरे पास हर चीज़ मौजूद है, मतलब डिलीवर क्यों नहीं कर पाता, ये मेरा इशू है मेरे साथ, तो मुझे पहले ये बताइएगा तो आपकी बड़ी मेहरबानी होगी। थैंक यू सो मच।
अच्छा अरे
यस सर,
इसके बाद कोई और क्वेश्चंस हैं कि नहीं, इस पे एंड करें फिर?
नो नो सर, आई थिंक दैट वाज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन। आफ्टर दिस सेशन इफ एनीवन हैज एनी क्वेश्चंस, दिस वीडियो इज लाइव ऑन आवर फेसबुक पेज एंड यू ऑल कैन सी सर तारिक्स कांटेक्ट्स, यू कैन ऑलवेज आस्क हिम, यू कैन ऑलवेज अप्रोच आवर प्लेटफॉर्म इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग दिस ट्रेनिंग एंड वी विल श्योरली गेट बैक टू यू, बट फॉर दिस सेशन सर दिस वाज आवर लास्ट क्वेश्चन।
ओके, सो the question that Adila Saiba and Shafkat Saab raised here is basically dono takriban similar hi hain, both of them has the motivation, the platform, try dono kar rahe hain, ek political party se affiliated hain, apne ideas share karna cha rahe hain, dusri already mentorship mein thoda bahut unhone try kiya, article writing kar rahi hain, sab kuch kar rahi hain, And seriously, Adila, I can relate to you because I have been through that particular stage as well. Ideas deliver karna nahi kar pate ke logon ke samne heartbeat badh jati hai, tangen kamna shuru ho jati hai. To be very honest, itne saalon ke baad, main jab aaj to khair, main kursi pe baitha hoon, lekin aaj bhi jab main aap logon ke samne aa raha tha, to meri tangen tab bhi kaanp rahi thi. It's natural. इंसान है हम, राइट? सो इंसानियत के नाते जो फियर हमें अल्लाह ताला ने हमारी एक सिफ्त में डाली हुई है, तो उसको ओवरकम करना तो हमारे ही नॉलेज में है ना. वो सिफ्त और वही तौफीक तो हमें भी, वो भी अल्लाह ताला ने दी हुई है. सो इट्स बेटर. इसका एक ही सलूशन है कि आप अपने आइडियाज को प्रॉपरली किसी को डिलीवर कर पाए ताकि लोग उसको सुन सकें और समझ सकें. तो इट्स आप उसको प्रिपेयर करें. आपको जो स्पीच देना है या कोई डिलीवरी करनी है, कोई प्रोग्राम में एंकरशिप करनी है, उसको पहले प्रिपेयर करें. प्रिपेयर करने के बाद जब आप वो डिलीवरी करेंगे तो उसमें आपको हर रात आपकी नींदें हराम होंगी, रोजाना नए आइडियाज आएंगे, लेकिन ज्यादा टाइम उसको नहीं देना. प्रिपेयर फॉर एटलीस्ट 2-3 डेज, इसलिए कि जितना लंबा टाइम देंगे वो उतना ही मॉडिफाई होता जाता है. 2-3 दिन अगर आपके पास हैं तो उसको प्रिपेयर करें. इस हद तक प्रिपेयर करें कि आप उसमें कंफर्टेबल हो जाए, आपकी हर एक बात उसमें एड अप हो जाती है. उसके बारे में थोड़ा लिखें, उसके बारे में थोड़ा सा पढ़ें, और जब आप लिख लेते हैं तो उनको उसको 2-3 दफा रिहर्स करें, फिर आपको पता होगा कि अब मैं अपना आइडिया प्रॉपरली डिलीवर कर रहा हूं कि नहीं कर रहा. पहले हम ये करते थे, मिसाल के तौर पर पहले जमाने में लोग, मैं भी इतना पुराना नहीं, जो पुराने लोग थे वो किसी को अपनी स्पीच सुनाते थे जो कि बड़े पॉलिटिशियंस थे. हमें तो अब कोई जरूरत ही नहीं है. सेल्फी मोड ऑन करो, वीडियो ऑन करो, डिलीवर द स्पीच इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू और उसको दोबारा प्ले करें और पता करें कि आपके उसमें क्या गलतियां हैं. एंड यू कैन करेक्ट योरसेल्फ इन योर ओन कंफर्ट ऑफ योर ओन होम. तो वो जो फियर्स आपकी हैं और आगे बढ़ने की मोटिवेशन है लेकिन हो नहीं पा रहा, तो दैट इज वो स्टेज फ्राइट की बात आ जाती है. आपने में वो मोटिवेशन है तो कैश ऑन इट, कोई भी प्लेटफॉर्म पैदा करें. शौकत साहब, आपके पास अगर कोई पोलिटिकल पार्टी की एफिलिएशन है तो उसका उसमें बहाने ढूंढे कुछ, आई एम सॉरी टू से, कोई ऑल फॉल बकने की, आई एम सॉरी, कुछ भी बोलें, 5 मिनट के लिए बोलें, लेकिन बोलें. जरूरी नहीं है कि स्पीच 15-15 मिनट की हो, 2 मिनट के लिए बोलें, 5 मिनट के लिए बोलें, लेकिन बोलें जरूर. ये प्रैक्टिस ही आपको रिफाइन करती रहेगी. यही प्रैक्टिस आप गाड़ी में अकेले जा रहे हैं, अपने साथ कोई टॉपिक चूज करके उस पर बात करना शुरू करें. और सबसे बड़ी चीज, सोशल मीडिया पे कुछ डालना है ना डालें, अपनी वीडियो अपने फोन पे सेल्फी मोड ऑन करके वीडियोस बनाते जाएं, बोलते जाएं, अपने खुद बहुत कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल बिल्ड होना शुरू हो जाएगा. यू आर योर ओन बिगेस्ट क्रिटिक ऑफ योर ओन सेल्फ. किसी और को जरूरत ही नहीं है आपको वो करने के लिए. एंड आई होप ये आपका क्वेश्चन इसमें आंसर हो गया होगा. और एट द एंड नोट, अल्लाह का बहुत बहुत शुक्र अदा करता हूँ कि उसने एक दफा फिर मुझे तौफीक दी, हमारे प्लेटफॉर्म को ये तौफीक दी कि हम आप लोगों के सामने हाजिर हुए और कुछ फ्रूटफुल बातें हुई. और अल्लाह का इस चीज़ पे भी बहुत शुक्र अदा करता हूँ. इज्जत देने वाला अल्लाह है कि इतनी लोगों ने पार्टिसिपेट किया. और अपने और मेरे ख्याल में मैं अपने सेशन को सक्सेसफुल इसलिए समझता हूँ कि हर एक बंदे ने वो चले अपनी स्पीच नहीं दी, लेकिन एटलीस्ट अपने एक्सपीरियंसेस हमारे साथ शेयर किए. एंड अगेन अल्लाह का बड़ा शुक्र है. Or whoever wants to get in touch with LaRep, they can, if they want to speak out on whatever the topic that they have. Obviously, social topic hona chahiye, matlab koi idhar udhar ki cheeze nahi. So, LaRep can guide you to through the whole process. Platform iske liye bana hai ki aap jaise young leaders ko mauka diya ja sake, us kaam mein lage ja sake. Inshallah, aapko next week ya usse agle week kisi aur topic aapke samne hazir hoonga. ये मेरे कॉन्टैक्ट्स हैं, इफ समबडी वांट्स टू गेट इन टच दे कैन. थैंक यू वेरी मच, जज़ाकअल्लाह.
थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर दिस इनसाइटफुल सेशन. आई एम श्योर कि जिन पार्टिसिपेंट्स ने आज पार्टिसिपेट नहीं भी किया, उस तरह शेयर नहीं किया, उन्होंने बहुत कुछ सीखा होगा. वी हैव रिसीव्ड टन्स ऑफ मैसेजेस इन आवर Zoom चैट एंड ऑल ऑफ देम आर थैंकिंग यू फॉर दिस ट्रेनिंग सेशन. सो थैंक यू फ्रॉम आवर साइड एज़ वेल. एंड एज सर तारिक हैज मेंशनड, इफ यू गाइस हैव एनी टैलेंट, इफ यू गाइस हैव एनी स्किल जिसको आप पॉलिश करना चाहते हैं, या कोई ऐसा टॉपिक है जिसपे आप चाहते हैं कि हम आपको ट्रेन करें, काइंडली आप वो भी हमारे साथ शेयर करें. वी विल अरेंज दैट फॉर यू एज वेल. एंड विद दैट नोट, थैंक यू सो मच एंड अलविदा.